what the snake here? Now, the snake is actually a symbol for fire. And so, saying that, fire and water is actually in clash. Okay, it's in clash. So, once you hear the ears in clash, you know that it will have a bit of turmoil. But we go more into that later. Okay? Okay, so see the ear being the snake ear, okay, this is the Grand Duke would be what we call the snake, which is in the southeast position, and the ear breaker is in the northeast position. So these two positions are a little bit more important for the ear. So if you were to renovate in these two positions, you will need to try and select a date. So certain dates you should not be actually renovating in these two positions. Okay, now most important to us when we do sign yuan feng shui is this chart. This is our annual chart. And this year, the 8th year in the center tells you this is our periodic star. It happens every 20 years. We are currently in the period 8. Alright? So these are the stars that has flown to this year's angle 5. So in the southeast, alright, so if your house faces southeast, you have a 4-7 star. And the 4-7 star talks, 7 is about the mouth and 4 is about the wind. So when you have a 4-7 star, it means that you might, okay, you might end up with arguments, heated arguments. So when if you are staying in a house that has the front with the southeast, then you have to take caution about how you say what you say. Alright? Not don't say, but how you say. Alright? In the east, you have a 3-6 star, which gives on the meaning of father and son. But father and son here don't get along because 6 is metal, 3 is wood. So they are going against one another. So if your house is facing the east, then for this year, sons and fathers will have a bit of tension. So you have to take care on that level. Alright? Northeast has a 2-8. And 2-8 here signifies ending of things. Okay, it could be a relationship, it could be a job. So if your jobs are like you're doing contractual jobs, then it could show that the contract is ending and that, you know, there could be new beginnings. Because remember, when there's ending, then only can there be beginnings. Alright? Yeah. Now, the North has a 1-4 star. Now, when a 1-4 star comes together, it means changes. So anyone in a North facing house this year, alright, expect some changes. Okay? Therefore, you see, Simon, your son will move out. Okay? So expect changes. Okay, now Northwest has 6-9, and 6-9 here talks about the leader with fire on the head. So here, if you are facing the Northwest, then you can say that the man in the house will have many challenges for the year. Okay, so pull up the pants and tighten the belt. You have to take charge this year and look into, dwell into why you are having this little problem. Okay? Now in the west you have a 7-1 star, and this 7-1 star talks about women, wine and music. So people here tend to have good time, want to have good time. Okay? So if you are facing the west, alright, and your husband is going out a lot, then you know it's because, you know, he has more entertainment for the year. Okay? This is usually the sign. Okay, in the southwest, a 2-5. Now, 2 and 5, 2 is builder star, but 2 is also pregnancy star. So the chances is people with this combination, you can expect good things because you can expect to have an additional family member. However, maybe a bit more difficult in during the pregnancy. So I have to look out for the woman who is pregnant. And in the south, you have a 9-3. 9 is fire. And fire, you know, when you're feeling angry, hot, right? So that's the 9 star bringing that on. So this 9-3 star, when you have it, tells you that these people in a south-facing house tend to be more temperamental. So the chances of losing temper is there. So keep calm, keep cool, you know, before you burst out, think a little bit before you explode. Okay? So these are the 8 facings and what you might encounter. Okay, so here we are going. I'm going to take you on a short preview of the houses. Now, the NO 9 star, as I have mentioned, is located in the south. All right, and this is an intellectual star because 9 is flamboyant, so it's very intellectual. You tend to want to show off for that year. Okay, now this is I'm just going to use a period 7 and period 8 star chart. Okay. They are both different because when you move into a house, your house has what we call a birth chart. So the birth chart will give you a chart, something like that. We are only going to consider the share market for the year. Take caution, okay? Take caution because a 5 star is always dabbling with danger. Alright? Now, the southeast with the 8 star and the 4 coming in is extramarital affair. Okay, so if you have a southeast 2-3 house, then that needs to be addressed. Alright? And the 3 star in the east, okay? 3 is about the throat. 3 signifies the throat. So if you have a 3 for the year, then you know you're going to talk a lot. Okay? It's an argument star, brings on temperamental vowels. Okay? So here, okay, east one facing a 3 with a 3. Now 3, another thing about 3 is fast moving. So 3 is a thief, okay, a burglar. So if you have an east facing house, then you have to take caution of burglary. Alright? Now in a period 8 house with an 8, the 3 come in, then you have to take caution of big problems, back problems. Okay, accidents that happen that you can injure your back. Alright, to try and help this, you can put strong fire. That means a very, very strong light in the east area of the house. Alright, now east 2, house 7 with a 3, same. Theft, burglary, have to be very careful of that. Okay, now actually, how do you ward off burglary if you know? So if you are actually staying in an east house and you know this might happen to you, how do you go off and ward this off? Okay, you can donate a little bit. Okay, so if you know of any like charities, small charities which you usually donate to, so this year you make more donations, smaller donations to a periodic of time to try and ward off this burglary stuff. Alright, and East 2-3 with the 3 coming in, this is total wood star. So when this comes together, people move around a lot, travel a lot. Alright? The last star which we are going to deal with is the southwest star, which has a 2 star. And 2 star, like I say, is illnesses. Alright? However, it can also bring you an abundance of children because it's also pregnancy star. Now, one thing about 2 star, so this year, if your door is southwest, the people in the house will tend to grow a little bit better because 2 is about earth, alright? Or if your bedroom is in the southwest, then it could also make you put on weight, alright? So, in a period 7 house, the 2 coming to the 7 tells me that 2-7, the chances of having fire problem, fire hazard is there. Okay? And in a south period 8 house, this 7 coming here tells me that the imminent chance of this person moving around, talking a lot, going further is very significant. Okay? Now, period 7 with a 4-1-7 coming in. Now, this house has wine, women, and song. So meaning to say, lots of entertainment for people who are staying in a Southwest 2337 house. Okay, and for a Southwest 2 house, who is people who are in period A, people are already very spiritual. So with the 7 coming in, you tend to dwell not into the mainstream spirituality, but you would also deviate a little into going to look at other spirituality methods. Okay? Okay, star 1 in the north. Okay? Star 1 is intelligent, 1 is the sign of water. So you are always going here and there. Okay? So this is the sign of movement. Okay? Star 1 is what we call a good star. So in the period 7 north 1 facing house, this signifies people moving away, people moving to higher areas, but it also signifies this house has wealth for the year. So if you are in the north house, it tells me that chances of making money is really there. Okay? Both period 7 and period 8. Alright? Now in period 7 house, north 3 facing, the double 7 with the 1 tells me you have lots more entertainment, you go out a lot, you stay out more in this particular house. Okay? And in a period 8 house with this star chart, it tells me that the chances of having illnesses, especially related to the heart, is very possible. So do take care. Do make sure that you do your annual checkups. Alright? So knowledge is power. Because we have gone through the different star charts, you know what your house facing is. So you know what imminent problem you might face. So you must address it.